The Northern Territory parliamentary year is officially over, and while the silly season hasn't quite hit the wider world, politicians seem under its influence. The Speaker said the last day was disintegrating into a circus.
It's a sure sign the end of the year is nigh. The Chief Minister's been giving out presents, not just Christmas cakes this year, but public houses to seniors who are downsizing. But many on the public housing list could be waiting many more Christmases for such a gift. The opposition pulled out official figures showing the wait even for older public housing is about 5 years.
Young people are telling me that they can't afford to stay in Darwin. What we're seeing is the breakup of the family units.
In the big house, the parliamentary one, there was no Christmas cheer. The opposition believed it had dirt to dish over spending on a campaign to see Uluru named as one of the seven natural wonders of the world.
Minister, what due diligence did you do to justify spending $86,000 of taxpayers' cash on this cash for comment scheme?
You are very, very close to accusing the Northern Territory Tourism of bribery.
It all became a bit much for the Speaker.
Member for Catherine, you do not have the call and you're already on a warning, you're now on two next time and you're out for an hour.
The rabble continued despite rebukes, the gavel and the ex-teacher death stare. The Speaker won't be the only one relieved the parliamentary year is over. Terry Mills has survived as opposition leader despite the rumblings. Former Labor Minister Alison Anderson has settled in as a member of the Country Liberals and both parties got through without any major scandal. But next year, the stakes rise. An election is on its way. Katrina Bolton, ABC News.